Floor Leader.
Mr. President, we have pending matters. As a matter of fact, number one on the list is the request for a subpoena by the prosecution panel.
That is correct. And the Senate has resolved the issue and has written a resolution of this particular issue, and I'm now directing the majority floor leader to read the resolution of the court disposing this issue. Order.
Shall I read the entire resolution, Mr. President?
Yes, in toto.
Resolution. This resolves the twin requests for issuance of subpoena, both dated January 31, 2012, filed by the House of Representatives. On January 31, 2012, the House of Representatives, through its prosecutors, filed a request for issuance of subpoena seeking to require the President, Manager, and or other authorized officers of Philippine Savings Bank, PS Bank, to testify and produce before the court the original and certified true copies of the following documents. A. Customer identification and specimen signature card of the bank account under the name Renato Corona, which won 1 million pesos in the PS Bank Monthly Millions Raffle Promo as listed in the official list of winners as of March 13, 2008. B. Monthly bank statements from the time of opening to January 2012 of the bank accounts under the name Renato Corona, which won 1 million pesos in the PS Bank Monthly Millions Raffle Promo as listed in the official list of winners as of March 13, 2008. C. Other bank accounts, including time deposits, money market placements, peso, dollar accounts, and the like, that are in the name of Renato Corona and or Cristina Corona. On the same date, the prosecution filed another request for issuance of subpoena seeking to require the manager of the Bank of the Philippines Islands, BPI, to testify and to produce before this court the original and certified true copies of the account opening form, monthly bank statements for January 2005 to December 2010 and December 2011 of bank account number 1443-8030-61 in the name of Renato C. Corona, which was referred to in exhibits triple V and triple V1 and such other accounts that are in the name of Renato Corona and or Cristina Corona. The defense opposed both requests through its opposition to the request for issuance of subpoena, PS Bank, in opposition to the request for issuance of subpoena, both dated January 31, 2012, which it both filed on February 1, 2012. The prosecution filed a reply dated 2 February to the two oppositions to the request of issuance of subpoena. On February 3, 2012, the prosecution filed its supplementary request for subpoena reply, designating therein the particular bank accounts in PS Bank, which the Chief Justice allegedly has. For its part, the defense filed a consolidated opposition and rejoinder. The court resolves to grant the issuance of the subpoena, but sets specific limits to the same. In determining whether the production of the documents described in a subpoena duces tecum should be enforced by the court, it is proper to consider, first, whether the subpoena calls for the production of specific proof, and secondly, whether the proof is prima facie sufficiently relevant to justify enforcing its production. A general inquisitorial examination of all books, papers, and documents of an adversary conducted with a view to ascertain whether something of value may show up will not be enforced. It is jurisprudentially accepted rule in this jurisdiction that in order to entitle a party to the issuance of a subpoena duces tecum, it must appear by clear and unequivocal proof that the book or document sought to be produced contains evidence relevant and material to the issue before the court. and that the precise book, paper, or document containing such evidence has been so designated or described that it may be identified. After an examination of the documents sought to be produced in both requests, this court is of the strong view that the production of documents pertaining to the bank accounts of Chief Justice Renato Corona should be closely related to the filing of his statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth, inasmuch as the funds in said bank accounts may be considered as his personal properties, which are required to be properly and truthfully declared in the SALN. The court takes due notice of the fact that the date of the SALNs of the Chief Justice are all dated as of the 31st day of December of the years 2002 to 2010. Thus, it is reasonable to issue the subpoena for the production of bank records as of the 31st of December for the years requested. The court has had to consider whether or not the issuance of the subpoena would violate existing laws on secrecy of bank deposits. Under Republic Act 1405 as amended and the Anti-Money Laundering Act, the disclosure of information relating to bank accounts in local currency cannot be made except in five instances, namely, A, upon written permission of the depositor, B, in cases of impeachment, C, upon order of a competent court in the case of bribery or dereliction of duty of public official, or when the money deposited or invested is the subject matter of the litigation, and E, in cases of violation of the Anti-Money Laundering Act. However, it appears that for foreign currency bank accounts, the disclosure may be made only upon written permission of the depositor pursuant to Section 8 of Republic Act No. 6426. However, the court has taken due notice of the fact that the Supreme Court has, in several decisions, relaxed the rule on the absolute confidential nature of bank deposits, even foreign currency deposit accounts, in the cases of Salvacion versus the Central Bank of the Philippines, GR number 94723, August 21, 1997, and China Banking Corporation versus Court of Appeals, GR number 140687, December 18, 2006, and Ejercito versus Sandigan Bayan, GR numbers 157294-95, November 30, 2006. The majority is of the view that the present impeachment proceedings present a valid exception to the general rule on confidentiality of information on bank accounts, even for foreign currency bank accounts. The court would like to emphasize that the non-disclosure of information relating to the bank accounts of individuals is still the general rule, and it has no intention of going against the public policy on this matter. However, the court is only issuing the subpoena relating to the bank accounts of Chief Justice Corona because of the pendency of the present impeachment proceedings and for no other reason. Wherefore, in view of the foregoing, the majority votes to grant the prosecution's request for subpoena to the responsible officers of the Philippine Savings Bank and the Bank of the Philippine Island for them to testify and bring and or produce before the court documents on the alleged bank accounts of Chief Justice Corona, only for the purpose of the instant impeachment proceedings as follows. A, the branch manager of the Philippine Islands, Ayala Avenue Branch, 6th floor, SGB Building, 6758 Ayala Avenue, Makati City, is commanded to bring before the Senate at 2 p.m. on February 8, 2012, the original and certified true copies of the account opening forms, documents for bank account number 1445-8030-61 in the name of Renato C. Corona, and the bank statements showing the balances of the said account as of December 31, 2005, December 31, 2006, December 31, 2007, December 31, 2008, December 31, 2009 and December 31, 2010. B, the branch manager and or authorized representative of Philippine Savings Bank, Katipunan Branch, Katipunan Avenue, Loyola Heights, Quezon City, is commanded to bring before the Senate at 2 p.m. on February 8, 2012, the original and certified true copies of the account opening forms documents for the following bank accounts allegedly in the name of Renato C. Corona, and the documents showing the balances of said accounts as of December 31, 2007, December 31, 2008, December 31, 2009, and December 31, 2010. 089-19100037-3, 089-13100282-6, 089-121-017358, 089-121-019593, 089-121-020-122, 089-121-021-681, 089-141-007-12-9, 089-141-007-46-9, 089-141-00814-5, and 089-121-011-95-7. So ordered, 6th February 2012. Signed, presiding officer, Juan Ponce Enrile.
Majority, what is the pleasure of the defense counsel?
Thank you, Your Honor. I would like to announce on record, Your Honor, that we are seeking a reconsideration of the aforesaid ruling in the light of the jurisprudence, more recent jurisprudence on the point, dealing with the issues discussed in this case, Your Honor. If the court so allows, I'm prepared to argue our points, Your Honor. But if the court pleases, we may file a written motion for reconsideration, Your Honor. As of this moment, I just would like to touch on one important point, Your Honor.
Proceed.
And that is the case of Ejercito versus Sandigan Bayan, Your Honor, was cited as an authority for the resolution of this honorable court, Your Honor. There were several property, there were several documents required by the Sandigan Bayan to be produced by Mr. Ejercito. One of the grounds is that he is not, for a refusing or motion to quash, rather the subpoena, was that he is not involved in the plunder case before the Honorable Sandigan Bayan. But the more important thing is this, Your Honor. What is the difference of the setting, factual setting of that case with the present case? The Arab case, Your Honor, is a plunder case. And the main allegation in that plunder case is that the accused President Arab committed acts constitutive of plunder resulting in the amassing of ill-gotten wealth, Your Honor. So the issue of ill-gotten wealth was principally and categorically raised, Your Honor, in the proceedings, Your Honor. This case is not a criminal case, Your Honor. It is an impeachment case, Your Honor. Now, there are provisions in the bank secrecy law that in cases of 1405, Your Honor, impeachment is an exception. What does that mean? That when the case is involves impeachment, then the privacy of bank deposit may no longer be invoked. That is correct, Your Honor. And we agree with that 100%. But it must be shown that the impeachment case has something to do with the alleged deposits, Your Honor. If the bank deposits has nothing to do with the impeachment case, Your Honor, the mere fact that it is involved in the impeachment proceedings does not justify any court of justice to rule against the privacy, Your Honor. The issue is it enough that the case is an impeachment case in order that the exemption may be claimed, Your Honor? Our answer is no, simply because the case is an impeachment case. But the subject matter thereof is not in connection with this impeachment case, Your Honor. It is not. For instance, certain documents, Your Honor, such as checks, Your Honor, were issued and negotiated in the case in an impeachment case, but they have nothing to do with the issue involved in the impeachment case. It is not a case of unlawful exercise of the right of issue bank checks, Your Honor. Neither is it involved in the issue principally involved in the impeachment case. In that case, the exemption holds water. The privacy of the bank deposits may not be inquired into. I just wanted to emphasize the point that the nature of the proceedings is not conclusive as to the bar a bank depositor from claiming the privilege under the bank. If we will be given the opportunity, Your Honor, we will submit our motion for reconsideration. I just went that far in order to show to the Honorable Court our interest in the ruling made in today's proceedings, Your Honor.
Mr. President.
In the view of this chair, your Mr. Defense Counsel, it is the right of any person, party to a case like this, to